go out to a live report here in Phoenix, Arizona. We've been seeing this picture go viral on Twitter of Jake Angeli. He is seen in the Capitol with horns on and fur and everything. He's been known as the QAnon Shaman. To break down the latest in his arrest, I have Fox 10's Justin Lum here with us. Justin, can you explain what happened today for both him and we saw some pictures earlier, some live video of his mother coming out of the courthouse?
Yeah, Jake Angeli, known as Jake Angeli, but he is Jacob Chansley. His mom came out of the courthouse after the ruling made by a federal judge to keep him detained in custody and not be released on any conditions whatsoever. She declined to comment, but yes, she was in the courtroom for Jake Angeli's appearance. He appeared on video in the orange jumpsuit, not what we're used to seeing him in the outfit that he has worn to many protests here locally here in Phoenix, Arizona, and also at Washington, D.C. on January 6th. But ultimately, the federal judge called Chansley a serious flight risk and danger to the community, especially with President-elect Joe Biden's inauguration coming up. And she ruled that he shall remain in custody. At some point, he will be taken back to Washington, D.C. for further prosecution. But basically, there are six counts against Chansley, including four misdemeanors and two felonies, specifically accused of obstructing law enforcement to affect and impede the certifying of the Electoral College vote, also accused of civil disorder and threatening congressional officials. Now, court documents say Chansley left a note for Vice President Mike Pence after he stormed the Capitol with a six-foot spear during the deadly riot on January 6th. The note said, "It's only a matter of time. Justice is coming." The government argues that the note is worded in a threatening manner. And in interviews with the FBI before Chansley's arrest, he allegedly expressed interest in going back to D.C., like I said, for the inauguration and also going to the Arizona State Capitol as well. Even though Chansley's attorney argued that, you know, GPS monitoring would be a reasonable condition for his release and that he has no criminal history, he's a veteran, the judge said she has no confidence that he would follow any court order if released. And after the hearing, like I said, his mother declined to comment, but a supporter of him who calls him a friend did have something to say.
"Right now, I think Jake is a good guy. He's an American citizen. Okay, please. No, he's an American citizen. He's a patriotic guy. Okay? I've never seen Jake ever do anything bad. He's been like a teacher, a role model. He's always tried to help people. And he's... It doesn't matter what you Democrats think. You can think whatever you want to think."
I can tell you there was a group of supporters just like this man, very passionate about what Jake Angeli says he stands for, and they were there to show support at this hearing. But ultimately, if convicted of these charges, he would face up to 25 years in prison.
Justin, I wonder if you can share anything about the history of Jacob here, because it's been interesting. We've been following all of these arrests, but they're coming from across the country, because it wasn't just, obviously, Washington, D.C. locals who were a part of that breach. So give us a little inside look as to what his history is in Phoenix, Arizona, and what his legacy is now with that whole group.
Well, he's a local guy, and with the costume that he wears, he's well known among Trump supporters, and we've seen him after the election at many protests here in Phoenix, Arizona, and he does travel. So he is well known here, known as the QAnon Shaman, like you said. But the judge also made a good point about keeping him detained, because when you look at him on the video conference call wearing a jumpsuit and without the costume, he looks totally different. So she did say that, you know, with that outfit that he's known for wearing, he remains notorious, but without it, he can look very anonymous and just look like the average young man in his early 30s. So for that was one of the reasons why she said she didn't have confidence in allowing him to be released, because of the possible option of him trying to flee and go back to Washington, D.C. And she even said, you know, there's possibility he could cut a potential GPS monitor. And at that point, he shook his head and said he wouldn't do something like that. And she told him, hey, you know, I'm talking right now. Let me continue on with the findings. But other than that, he was pretty emotionless through the hearing.
And I'm sure you mentioned this a little bit before. We didn't hear from his mom today. She said no comment to all of you guys. We were on that live picture as she walked out and said she's not speaking to the media. But what has she said in the past about her son?
Well, I never got the chance to interview his mother, Martha, but I know that she said that he's a patriot, being demonized. In the courtroom, she did mention a little bit to us, like when she looked at the video monitor during the judge's recess, she tried to wave at him. He couldn't see his mom. And she also said that he looks unhappy and mentioned to us that he has started to eat, because at one point he was not eating the food in jail. But that's pretty much what she's mentioned, and she just seemed very concerned about her son and his well-being. And after the court hearing, she was gone.
Yeah, well, this will obviously be a continuing story here, and we'll follow it on News Now from Fox with you, Fox 10's Justin Lum. We appreciate you being here with us.
Thank you.
And again, the latest on News Now from Fox. Right before we hit Justin there, we were showing you the latest tweet from Washington, D.C.'s police department. This right here is one of the suspects that is, I'm assuming, their latest investigation that they're taking a look at. He is suspected to be the person who used a police shield to pin Officer Hodges up against the door jamb. I showed you some of that shocking video right before we had this report in Phoenix, and we'll be hitting any of these updates from the FBI, from Washington, D.C.'s police department, police departments from across the country as they continue to get leads on people who were at the Capitol, inside, breaching the Capitol. But we also showed you that press conference of that retired Chicago firefighter who was wrongly accused of being at the Capitol and committing murder even. So it goes both ends of the aisle. If you have any solid information, they are asking to reach out, 1-800-CALL-FBI. We're going to leave you with this live look at the Capitol here as it continues to be topic of discussion.